ces personnes affirment avoir vu longuement et à plusieurs reprises
des... The Belgian sightings of the late 1980s and early 90s are some of the most widespread in history, with over 2,000 well-documented and researched reports by pilots, police, and military professionals.
I thought this is an intrusion of our airspace. We have to find out because it's an air defense issue.
The 18-month epidemic of UFO sightings rattles the Belgian government and brings the scientific community its most conclusive piece of UFO evidence to date.
I look at it and said, oh my God, that's too much. My feeling at the time, I must admit it was a fake.
This is the Belgian Wave.
My name is Patrick Ferrin, and I was one of the two co-founders of SOBEPS, which is a non-profit association devoted to the study of aerial space phenomenon. In 1989, the situation was very quiet here in Belgium concerning UFOs. So quiet that we decided to close the association because there was no sighting anymore. And all of a sudden, strange things started to happen in the area of Eupen. And this was, historically speaking, the beginning of the Belgian UFO wave.
My name is Albert Kreutz. On the evening of November 29th, 1989, I was the dispatcher at the Eupen police station.
At around 5:30 p.m., a team of police officers informed Kreutz of an object flying over a nearby field and reportedly lighting it up like a soccer stadium.
I joked with them, since it was the end of November, that it was St. Nicholas coming down. Then they screamed, "Look out your top floor window, and you'll see it." I go to the window, and I see the object about 200 or 300 meters in front of me, like a boat floating in the sky. It was magnificent to see, and it made me think that we are not alone on this earth, in the universe. I found it beautiful.
Immediately, the dispatcher is flooded with calls from concerned citizens. So he orders local officers stationed nearby to follow the object. One of these is Dieter Plomans, chief inspector of the Kelmis police force. Plomans is on duty with his partner, catching drug dealers near the Netherlands border, when the call comes in.
When we heard the call on the radio, we were driving in this direction. We saw a light or some type of object resting over the town of Henri Chapelle. And we asked ourselves, what is that?
I told them to pursue the object and observe it. So they followed it to Henri Chapelle, where the object hovered motionless over the Beloeil retirement home.
I think this is pretty much the exact spot where we stopped at the time. We saw a huge object above us with round lights on three corners. And at some point, a much smaller object flew out from behind. And it had a reddish blinking light that blinked in rhythm with the larger light.
Plumans and his partner observe the objects for several minutes, and then suddenly the red orb is reeled back into the larger craft.
Das Objekt.
The object then rose up and flew away.
Kreutz and Plumans' accounts are among the many that began to flood in that night. In all, a total of 13 police officers called in reports of an unidentified triangular craft spotted in 8 different locations around Eupen. Over 60 additional civilian reports are made that evening, producing a concentrated mass of sightings that would soon bring international media attention and compel the Belgian government to respond.
It was really an historic night because the sighting reports were also similar. But the big surprise was that this was only the beginning.
Des personnes affirment avoir vu longuement et à plusieurs reprises des objets volants et lumineux de forme triangulaire.
Ils ont vu dans le ciel un phénomène étrange, un ovni.
The day after November 29, it was a huge covering in the media.
Résultat des interactions entre les forces cosmiques.
It was on TV, it was in the newspaper, everywhere. And immediately we took our car and we went to Eupen to interview the people who saw it.
Mon mari a vu quelque chose de tout à fait incroyable la nuit de lundi. Et il a vu un objet énorme avec d'immenses rayons lumineux qui l'a suivi pendant plusieurs minutes alors qu'il rentrait à la maison. Voilà, il n'ose pas en parler parce qu'il a peur qu'on se moque de lui, mais moi je tiens quand même à vous en informer.
We collected 150 different sightings from the same area, describing almost the same thing.
Donc ça forme un triangle.
A huge, triangular, dark object.
Avec chaque extrémité, un grand feu blanc.
C'est vraiment comme des phares d'atterrissage d'un avion, mais à beaucoup plus fort. Hein, parce que ça vient de chasse voir.
Et au milieu de celui-ci, un gros clignotant rouge.
What is very interesting is that triangular object wasn't reported at the time, in 1989. At the time, in ufology, people were speaking about flying saucers, discs, something like that, but not a triangular, dark shaped object. This was new.
The Belgian sightings of November 29th garner international attention, prompting an immediate response from the government. A point man is assigned to head up the government inquiry. Major General Wilfred de Brouwer, head of operations for the Belgian Air Staff.
In 1989, I was in charge of protection of the airspace of the country when a total of 143 sightings were reported in the area of Eupen. When receiving such report at military level, a lot of officers will reject it because it's not in their terms of reference. It's frustrating. It's frustrating having to declare that you don't know what is going on. So when it came to my office, I wanted to react it the same way. But I thought this is an intrusion of our airspace. We are the country hosting NATO. We have to find out because it's an air defense issue.
De Brouwer's first action is to contact the U.S. Embassy to find out if any stealth flights had taken place in the area without warning them.
Now, they came back very quickly and confirmed formally that no such flights had taken place over Belgium. So that wiped out that theory.
But the sightings continue, including many cases where several people were involved in a single sighting. Police officers, military and government personnel, and an Air Force weather forecaster.
Highly credible witnesses, all of them convinced that they saw something exceptional.
One of the cases that most intrigues de Brouwer occurs just 2 weeks after the initial sightings, when several witnesses report a triangular-shaped craft near the rural town of Ernage. De Brouwer is particularly struck by the account of Colonel André Amand, a civil engineer who is also director of infrastructure for the Belgian army.
Je quittais la maison.
I was driving from my house, my wife by my side, to go pick up my son at the Gembloux train station. I noticed three yellow panels moving parallel with me beside the road. Under them was a pulsating red light.
Je comprenais pas du tout.
I did not understand what it was. My wife said it's probably just a plane. But I wanted to see it, so I slowed down. And the object stayed with my car. So I accelerated and slowed down two or three more times. And every time, the UFO would catch up with me. Then the UFO traveled behind the Sarnege woods. So I turned left and stopped on a small hill in front of a farm. The UFO came out from behind the woods over there. I saw a huge, bright white beacon come over until it was about 100 meters in front of us. You could hear traffic on the highway and a train going by about 1 kilometer away. But at no point could you hear any noise coming from this object only 100 meters in front of us. We observed it for 6 to 8 minutes. And then my wife says, Andre, come on, get in the car. I don't like this. And at that point, the great white beacon retreats and it darts away to the southwest in about the time it takes to let out a breath. In my experience, that kind of acceleration requires a very large amount of energy that wouldn't be possible without materials that could superconduct at a low temperature. And today, 20 years later, I know one thing. There is no man-made object able to do what I saw that object do that day. Not then and still not now. It's impossible.
Colonel Amon sends a report to the Ministry of Defense and is one of the many military...